Hey, what's up, guys? So, I'm standing here next to this gorgeous honey, and I think what I'm going to do today is I'm going to put Jake brakes on, and exhaust manifold, turbo pipe, coolant pipe, and then we'll see if this thing will start and run for real. Check it for leaks, see how it goes. Looks like it's quite leaky, but I think it was from the fountain youth that was blowing around down there. So we'll see. Let's get after it. Let me try not welding. I just want to see if this fits. I guess it fits. Yep. So I guess I only need just one more. This one actually has a lot of oil on it. So I'll take this one and look for another one. Ouch. Yeah, that was funny. That oil shot up on like a fountain. All right. I'm pretty sure that this one right here. Good. And this one here was a very front one. So I lost a little rubber from around my drill down the valve cover or down the rockers. So let me get a light and see if I can't fish it out there. Oh, I see it's right there. No big deal. Go get it. Trying to be slick is what happened in there. I'm gonna get rid of that because it's just a liability at this point. Let's get the ratchet and try and torque that one down that's not tight. Uh, other one didn't tighten. So, get a look at it. Yeah, that one's tight. This one might not clear the valve cover. Let's get a valve cover and get a look at it. I'm guessing it's not going to clear. Let's find out. I think with the gasket that'll fix. We'll see. Yeah, I think that'll clear, especially with the gasket. So we'll put the valve covers on. I'll find the gasket for this one. Stick it on there right quick. These gaskets are pretty thick, so should create as much clearance as it needs. And then we'll leave these, we'll leave them loose, but we won't. We'll run them down. This one has a broken bolt, so it's probably going to leak anyway. So we'll have to take this valve cover, and we'll leave the valve cover on to protect the engine from shavings. We'll get the water manifold on, and we'll get this, we'll drill this one out and use a easy out to get it. It's not the right one. It ain't Mr. Right, but it's Mr. Right now, if you know what I mean. So I need to find this other O-ring, because it's for that coolant pipe. And there it is right there. So there's the two O-rings. I'm gonna wire wheel this coolant pipe. I don't think you guys need to watch that. I'll be right back with you. So I put O-rings in there. I'm not sure if that's right or not. This pipe doesn't seem to like being in there. What did I do with it? Right there. All right, so I don't know if that'll stay or not. It's got new O-rings in it. We'll plug the jakes in. I didn't see any way to actuate them anyway, so it's not a huge deal, but that way the wire doesn't get pinched between the exhaust and the unit there. I'll get the exhaust manifold and turbo over here. That thing weighs like 2 tons, so I don't really know. I don't have a strategy right now for getting it on there. I think what I'll do is I'll get one bolt ready to go, and I'll put the gaskets on, and I'll get the turbo on there and just get one bolt started, and we'll see how that pans out, because the thing is monstrously heavy. Let me see what we got bolt wise, and that's heavy. Now what I can do is I can try and get it on the oil return line, and that'll help hold it up, but I just don't know if that's a thing. Oh, that's not a thing for sure. Shit. Okay, I knocked one gasket off. Shouldn't fall off again. Yep. All right, rather than stick with this over and over, we're gonna put some glue on all of them, and that way if I do get it up there, I don't have to worry about it coming back down, you know, having to get it back down because one of the gaskets slipped out. So I'll just put the glue on all of them, and what I mean by glue is it's just RTV sealant, and it's ultra gray, because I hate the way that other stuff smells. Come on, you. Okay, and then one fell off, so I might could get that one back on. And I think one rolled down, which rolling down is not a big whoop. Maybe I should start another bolt. I'm sweating for sure. Come on now. Where'd that one go? All right, so I got all the bolts in. Got them all cleaned up. I got them in. I'm just gonna tighten them up by hand. I put a little bit of anti-seize on 8 of them, just because I already had 4 in, and when I thought about it, and so I cleaned all the threads. Yeah, I don't even have a 5/8 over here, so I'm just going to use the wrench, which is going to be more than adequate for right now. on the pins now. God dang it. I busted another brand new can. Well, that's $20 I wasted. 2 days. Just by knocking cans off the truck. Okay, start up. Hold on. It needs me to intervene, but I don't know if I can get over here. Shut it off, huh?
Spider right in my face.
Nice. Big one? Well, ain't that special. The turbo works, blew the pipe off, which I assumed it was going to. Ain't got no clamps on it. Man, it seems like it runs really good. Now the only hope is gonna be, when I hook up the cooling system, is it gonna be fully functional and not leak? So I guess that's what I'll do next, is I'll plumb in the cooling system, get some valve covers on it, hook up this vent tube, change the oil, and hope for the best. Now, it runs really good. So good stuff, guys. We'll get back with you. got a hard stop right there. Not really sure why. Someplace right here where the issue's gonna be. Those valves used to plug in. These big old open holes. that's a nice place for hair dryers. It's got stuff down there. I strip those puppies off. Clean those valves up in the cap and the spray liners. These are just plastic lines. So it's not a big deal to keep them rinsing off. What's up, guys? So we're expecting some cold weather. I don't think it's gonna get freezing, but I'm going to warm up Candy and warm her up and get some more fluid in. Jake's trying to get some
band coming on.
Tried though, didn't have to be perfect. I don't know what I want to do. Maybe put Crystal back in over there and then put Trisha in front of that door and Candy in front of that door. What do you think? No, yes, yes.
I think they're fine.
Just leave them there and leave this one in the mud?
It's not in the mud. And plus, it's not going to be raining. It's just cold, so it's not like it's going to sink.